So Chris finally got with the times and finally finished Stranger Things.
It's got been with
so
the times, got with the 80s.
Since I've seen it, yeah, I mean, this is the theme of the show. So we've got Corey Feldman. Unfortunately, he was not in Stranger Things.
Yeah.
But Winona Ryder was. How did you like her in Stranger Things?
She, was just wonderful.
She was great at playing a crazy lady. But not she's not crazy. Crazy,
yes, that's the
thing.
The whole thing. And she even, references that when she's talking to people. She's like, I know, I sound crazy, but I'm absolutely not crazy, which is what every fucking crazy person says.
Right. I know this may sound crazy, but hear me out. So Stranger Things does a really good job of kind of capturing the feel of an old 80s television show and horror movies. And they do it without... They've managed to make a show set in the 80s that does not have that tongue-in-cheek, hey, remember the 80s kind of vibe to it, which a lot of shows that kind of go back, you know,
I do have one thing to
previous times.
I do have one thing to say. When we talk about South Park a little bit later on in the episode, that is going to come back.
Okay.
But yes, no, they absolutely stayed away from that horrible trope of 80s nostalgia.
Yeah.
You know, hey guys,
please.
Yeah.
You know, and no,
because it just straight up, it takes place during the 80s and it has an amazing soundtrack for the 80s.
Right. Another show that is set in the 80s that just started their third season, which I think you should watch, is called Halt and Catch Fire.
I have heard of that, and it sounded really interesting.
Lee Pace is in it, and he plays a bisexual man.
In the 80s?
In the 80s, no less.
My God.
And I'm really into the history of computing, because I grew up around it. My dad was really into it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I don't remember a time in my life, and I'm you know, almost 35 this month. And I don't remember a time in my life that we didn't have a PC in the house at some point, let alone more than one. My dad built me my first PC when I was 4.
Wow.
Okay, that was in 1985.
Wow. Right?
So, I mean, that's why, you know, that's why I ordered that vintage Model M keyboard.
Yeah.
That I got. I'm still waiting on it. It's in customs. But so that I have a lot of nostalgia for the 80s. I was born in 1981.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I grew up in the 80s. You were born when?
87.
87. So you were 4 years old.
Yeah,
when
I was
90s
about to say,
hit.
I was a child of
the
90s.
So you don't really remember it kind of the way I do. And I don't really remember it the way someone born in 77, 75 would, or 71 like Corey Feldman,
because
he's 10 years older than me.
Yeah.
But that's the great thing about Stranger Things, is because it really manages to capture the feel of that time period and the feel of TV shows and movies from that time period.
Mm-hmm.
Even down to the Stephen King font for the logo. And
did
and
you
the
ever
chapters.
Watch Freaks and Geeks?
Yes.
I have only seen, I think, a handful of episodes.
It only lasted one season.
Yeah, it was one season, and I think it was only 13 episodes in the season. But, so I have watched, I think, the first 3 or 4 episodes.
Which was
set
in the 70s.
Yeah, but it was late mm-hmm. 70s. But, that show had a great, nostalgia, but not, the hey guys nostalgia feel to it. It was taking place at this time.
And I think that's important, especially for a show like Stranger Things, to be grounded in reality, even though it deals with a lot of
supernatural, very not real
kind of stuff.
All, yeah.
But at the same time, you know, it's very reality. Here's the thing though. Winona Ryder, arguably the biggest name on the show, haven't really heard a lot from her.
She hasn't.
The last
done
thing
a
I
lot.
Remember her doing was playing Spock's mom in the Star Trek reboot.
Yeah.
The first one.
Yeah.
And then she died.
Yeah.
So I think that Stranger Things has become kind of a phenomenon. It's kind of broken some Netflix records and a lot of people are talking about it. So it would not surprise me if we start hearing a lot more from Winona Ryder.
Well, and Tim Burton, Michael Keaton.
Great.
Yes, she does.
Yeah.
Tim Burton, Michael Keaton, and Winona Ryder rumored to be making Beetlejuice 2.
That's so crazy to me that they would even make another one.
Right?
And not that I don't like Beetlejuice.
Of
I love
course,
that movie.
Of course.
But at the same time, it was like, where do you even go from there?
Seriously. Because Lydia is now in her 40s.
Right.
Well,
we already know she's good at crazy. Maybe Lydia is in a insane asylum or something. Who knows?
It's, I mean, yeah, it's a world of possibilities is open for us with a Beetlejuice 2.
Right. Well, I
and
remember...
especially now that Winona Ryder is coming back to people's minds.
Yeah. Hey, remember Winona Ryder? She's relevant. Corey Feldman and Winona Ryder are both relevant in 2016. Can you believe it?
I can. At least for Winona Ryder, because Winona Ryer has been...
It's because all the good celebrities have already died this year.
Winona Ryder, that's horrible. I have loved Winona Ryder still. Like, even obviously, I saw Beetlejuice and Edward Scissorhands and stuff when I was a kid. Loved him. But then, like, she's in Mr. Deeds, isn't she? The Adam Sandler version?
She?
Yeah, she's
yeah,
the...
Yeah, she is.
Yeah. And she
fell
was
in the ice.
Yeah, and she was...
She was in Reality Bites.
I don't think I've ever seen that one.
Oh, dude, that's a 90s movie if there ever was one. Nice. Ben Stiller was in that.
Oh, nice. Uh-huh. But I was thinking of the, damn it, Keanu Reeves, Robert Downey Jr., Woody Harrelson, Winona Ryder. It's a Philip K. Dick book.
Rules of Attraction?
No,
no,
no.
No, 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 no. That's, no.
The animated
fucking...
one. It was like it was shot and then it was animated over it.
Yeah, it was rotoscoped. No, I know exactly the movie you're fucking
but
talking about.
That movie is amazing.
And, you know, when that movie came out...
Scanner Darkly.
Yeah, Scanner Darkly.
Scanner Darkly.
When that movie came out, that was kind of like, oh, there's Robert Downey Jr. Haven't really heard much from him in a while. And then all of a sudden, now he's...
Iron Man.
In one of the highest paid actors ever.
Exactly. And, Iron Man, there was a Sherlock
great,
Holmes.
If there was a great Robert Downey Jr., I mean, if there's a great comeback story, it's definitely in Robert Downey Jr.
Oh, yeah. Early 90s when he was really just in bad shape.
Yeah.
And then he got himself cleaned up.
But I remember, you know, I think it was at like a dinner party in a town I used to live in. And they were talking about Robert Downey Jr. And they were like, well, he, you know, Marvel made him. And I'm like,
are
dude,
you
he was
fucking
like,
kidding me.
He was like. Best actor for Chaplin, like
yeah.
You don't remember that? And I was like, he had a career before Iron Man. You,
oh my
you
God.
Are aware of this, right? And he's like, yeah, but it wasn't as big. I was like, no, he
Are
was
you
a pretty
kidding?
Big. He was a pretty big deal back in the day. Okay,
jeez.
And he was in Weird Science.
Yeah, yeah, he was. Oh, I love his character in that movie too.
All right, so anyway, Stranger
right,
Things.
But yes, we've kind of gotten sidetracked. Eating the member berries on this one. But yes, no, Stranger
remember
Things.
Remember Corey Feldman? Remember him?
Right.
Remember Winona Ryder? Go on.
Stranger Things, I really, really enjoyed it. Beginning to end, I thought, this show has got it. And I'm excited to see what they do for season two.
So here's the deal with season two, okay? So it's going to follow the same cast.
Yeah.
I think that could be a mistake. What I would like to see...
I want to see what they do with it.
Yeah.
If they are going to continue.
I would almost like to see...
An anthology
series
yeah.
out of that.
And I can see that. Absolutely, I could see
Winona
that.
Winona Ryder needs to have her schedule clear to go and do all these big blockbuster movies because she's super hot right now.
Yeah.
Her and Corey Feldman are going to co-star with each other. I don't know, have they ever been in a movie together?
Winona Ryder and Corey Feldman?
They will.
They will.
Now that they're both super hot.